Today, we are going to discuss measurement of distances of astronomical object by parallax method. So, this method is used to measure the distance of the star which is less than 100 light years. Now, let us assume this is the orbit in which Earth is revolving around Sun. Here is Sun and this is the orbit of Earth in which Earth is revolving. So this diameter is taken as baseline. This AB diameter is taken as baseline. Suppose this is the distance star S, whose distance from Earth we have to measure. So join this S with A and S with B. Now how we work out? First, suppose a particular day, say 22nd January, we measure the angle subtended by any distance star N with this star S, means we measure this angle phi 1 by astronomical telescope. We fix the astronomical telescope at point A. We focus a distance star N, and with respect to this star N, we measure the angle between the direction of N and S at point A. Let this angle be phi 1. So this measurement is done on 22nd January, say. After 6 months, that is on 22nd June, suppose Earth is reaching to point B. After 22nd June, Earth will reach to point B. Again at B, with respect to the same star N, we measure the angle phi 2, which is the angle between the direction of N and S. Now if we draw a line over here, then this phi 1 angle is equal to this phi 1 angle, alternate interior angle, and this phi 2 angle is equal to this phi 2 angle, alternate interior angle. Now this phi 1 plus phi 2 is equal to phi. This is called parallax angle. This is called parallax angle. Now once we measure phi, we can measure the distance small s between the star, this star S, and Earth. Now what is AB? Length of the line AB is equal to two astronomical unit. Length of this line AB is equal to 2 astronomical unit, which is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 11 meter. Now we have the concept for any circle. We know that central angle equal to arc by radius. If this angle is theta, this is O, this is A, this is B, and if the radius is R, then we write central angle theta equal to arc AB by radius R. Here also we can see that the central angle is phi. If you consider S as the center of a circle and AB as arc, then we can write that central angle phi in radian equal to arc AB, arc AB divided by SA or SB. If we consider this distance or this length of the baseline as B, then we can say phi equal to AB, that is 2 astronomical unit, divided by radius, which is equal to S. So it can be written as B by S. So S equal to B by phi. So knowing the value of B and knowing the value of this whole angle phi, which is equal to phi 1 plus phi 2, we can calculate S, small s, that is the distance between the sun and earth. Now we discuss indirect methods for measuring small distances. This method is used to measure the distance which is of the order of 10 to the power minus 10 meter, which is the size of an atom. Let m is the mass of the substance in gram, capital N is the Avogadro's number, and capital N is the Avogadro's number and capital M is the molecular mass. So you can say that number of atoms in 1 gram is N by M. So number of atoms in M gram is N by M into small m. Assuming each atom as the sphere of radius R. Suppose each atom is the sphere of radius R. Then what is the volume of the atom? It is 4 by 3 pi R cube. So, the volume of the atoms in m gram of the substance, volume of the atoms in m gram of the substance, m gram of the substance, what will be its value? Its value will be equal to n m by m into 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now, according to Avogadro's hypothesis, this volume is equal to 2/3 the volume of the substance itself. This volume is equal to 2/3 of the volume of the substance. So we can write M into N by capital M into 4 by 3 pi R cube equal to 2 by 3 into V, where V is the volume of the substance. Now all of you know volume equal to mass by density. So substituting the value of V in this equation, we get M into N by capital M equal to 4 by 3 pi into 4 by 3 pi R cube equal to 2 by 3 m by rho. Now if we cancel this m, then we get r cube equal to m divided by 2 pi n rho, and if you want to find out r, then it will be its power 1 by 3. Now knowing the value of m and rho, knowing the value of m and rho, the value of r, which is the size or radius of the atom, can be determined. Now we discuss molecular layer method. It is a practical method of finding the size of the molecules of a liquid having comparatively larger size, which is nearly equal to 10 to the power 9 meter. For example, oleic acid,
10 to the power minus 9
meter. For example, oleic acid. First, we prepare a solution of concentration, 1/400 of the oleic acid in alcohol, Now, we pour few drops, say n drops of the solution on the surface of water filled up to the thin layers on the surface of water. We carefully stretch the layer as much as possible by means of wax-coated glass strip. With the passage of time, the alcohol evaporates and only oleic acid layer left on the surface of water. The area of this layer is measured by using a tracing paper and millimeter graph paper. Let this area be a centimeter square. Let V is the volume of each drop of the solution. Then the volume of n drops of the solution will be nV/400 centimeter cube. So V is the volume of each drop of the solution and nV/400 is the volume of n drops of the solution. Now, it is spreaded in the form of layer of area a centimeter square we have considered. And if T is the thickness of the layer, then we can write A into T equal to nV/400. And from this, we can calculate T, which is nV divided by 400A. Now, what is T? T is the thickness. If we assume that the layer of oleic acid has been stretched to the extent that it has a thickness of one molecule, then the value of T obtained above give the diameter of one molecule of oleic acid.